Hello, friends. Welcome back to TerraFirmaCraft with more MC85 and RongotheBold.
Hey, guys.
So we have been exploring for a few days, hiding in little nooks and crannies as we try and find copper. And we finally found it. I've got 8 pieces and some more. How many do you have?
3.
Like 5, I think? 3 or 5?
I have 3, yes.
3 pieces. Okay. So that gives us enough. You need 100 units of copper to make your first tool. In this case, we're going to make a pick because when you find those surface ores, it's an indicator that there is more ore down below you. So we're hoping S'more is going to be doing some mining, and hopefully down underneath here we can find some additional ores. So we've set up a new little base on this island. S'more is going to craft himself a hoe.
Yep. Ta-da! Which I've done.
Plant our crops. Woohoo! Do you have space in your inventory?
Not much. I'm going to have a few more. So to do this, it's real similar to just regular Minecraft, right? You just right-click?
Yep, right-click. Now, if you hit, I think, B or M?
Yes.
On the hoe, it'll switch modes for the hoe, and it'll tell you if it's hydrated or if it is the crop is ready. And the very different thing is, the crops use nutrients. Each block has nutrients, A, B, and C, and each crop will use a different nutrient. So if you replant in the same spot with the same crop, it won't grow as well the second time. You got to kind of let it. Those you just put on grass.
Anywhere, or does it have to be near the water?
Yeah, anywhere. Those just go anywhere. Okay. Well, berry bushes. He's got berry bushes. Beautiful. I've got some more seeds for it if you want them. Got yellow peppers and maize and oat.
Okay, thank you.
So you want to once you get your farming up, you'll be able to, with the hoe, you'll be able to see which nutrients each crop uses. And then you can rotate the crops around on the soil to keep the ground from being overused.
Which makes sense. Kinda cool. Yeah.
Do you want to give me your copper and maybe a stack of clay?
Here is a stack of clay, and here is my copper.
Beautiful. Oh, here's the oat seeds.
Oh, good. Thank you. Whomp. I only planted everything in the wrong spot now, Rongo. Thanks.
Oh, that's okay. You can. It's the first farm. I mean, we'll be making a better farm. All right, so I am going to make... These are going to be our pit kilns. They're holes in the ground. They've got to be completely surrounded on all the sides, all the 8 sides and corners. And you take some clay like that, and you right-click on it, and this lets us create a vessel that we can use to fire up our clay. I'm also going to make a couple of jars. Clay jugs, so we can have water, which would be a good thing.
Oh, I remember how to do it. Yay! I also made clay jugs.
Yay! All right.
So
all you gotta do is
shift right click, right?
Yep, shift right click the object, and you can pop it down there.
Oh, what the hell?
Let me put my other things here. All right, so, isn't that beautiful?
Yeah, my chunk is disappearing real bad.
Aww.
Again, right? Oh, it's irritating.
Yeah, S'more's having some issues.
Yeah, if you guys know why it does this, feel free to throw that in the comment section. I've been playing around with it quite a bit, so. Maybe one of you fine folks knows why.
And I'm going to...
See, it's back now.
Right-click with some hay or straw, 8 pieces.
Damn it.
Whomp. And then... 8 pieces of any kind of wood. You can mix and match. It's no problem. Beautiful. And then use our fire lighter. Stand back. It's going to get fiery. Oh, fire. Now, take cooks for 8 hours, and that'll fire those clay vessels so we can use them. Well, I'm going to go ahead and make a couple of containers as well. Go ahead. You were going to say something?
My animations were off, so the fire looked a little redonkulous.
Ah.
Right. definitely running a lot smoother now too on my end. Just the chunks are not loading correctly, which is really irritating.
That's frustrating.
Yeah, so I'll look into it some more. No worries.
All right. So,
and it comes and
make
goes.
A couple large vessels, which are kind of nice big jugs for us to store stuff in. Now, the benefit of the vessels, the small ones, is we can carry them with us. We can actually carry these on our back and store a lot of goods as well, like a backpack.
Right.
All right. Yeah. More logs.
Is there very much to the spearfishing, Rongo?
I have not successfully spearfished.
Do I need to be able to actually see the fish first?
In the water? Yeah, you have to see the fish.
No.
And I have not found fish.
Huh.
Are you seeing fishes?
No. Well, there's a big hole right there. Yikes, what is up with that? Ugh.
Ooh. How far does it go?
Farther than I want to fall.
Ooh.
Now.
All right, so these are cooking. These are wood piles. Wood piles, you can shift, right-click, it creates a wood pile. You can put up to 16 pieces of wood in it, which is kind of cool. You can't put wood anywhere else, so you might as well put it in there. And then get it back out, just right-click, and pull it back out.
Marvelous.
Nice big hole there, too. Yikes. Also, notice that water doesn't flow over the edge quite the same.
Yeah, until you, like, break the edge, and then it'll start flowing.
Oh, gotcha. Okay. Also, just kind of keeping my eyes peeled for any more native copper just laying on the surface. So, Rongo, did we find enough pieces to make one pick?
Yep, we have enough to make one pick.
And then the idea is we tunnel down and we get more and we make
tunnel down
stuff.
And we hope and we pray that someday we will make more copper.
I did find a few more pieces.
You did?
Yes.
Awesome.
We just hold on to those for now.
A bookmark where that is?
Yeah, it's not far from the base.
Excellent.
See, and then the thing is trying to load. The chunk is, like, flickering like crazy. Ah, sigh. Big sigh. That's okay.
Now, food gets decayed, and you can hit D on it, and it'll chop the decay off. Because eating the decay is a bad... You don't want to eat decayed meat.
Okay. That's good to know.
And hitting D will chop the decay off everything in your inventory.
Ah.
Now, you can put things away... Like into my medium rare. There we go. Into vessels, and it'll slow the decay down. You can also do things like salt it, brine it, put it in vinegar, smoke it, dry it. There's a whole bunch of different ways to preserve foods, and we can explore all of them.
That sounds excellent and probably a good idea. Really enjoying the music and the mod too.
Oh yeah, the music is awesome.
Right.
Or this mod, I should say. What else should we need?
I feel like it's a really good feel for the game. So.
Yeah.
Now, just to the north, there is a very large ravine, and I think eventually we're gonna build a little bridge over there and maybe do our mining out of that. It's just over there.
So we've got this little... You said it was hematite you saw in there?
Yeah.
That's an iron ore. That's going to be very handy when we need our iron.
Yeah. So, and if the... what's the word I'm looking for? If all of the terraforming is a little expensive or painful, maybe we do less terraforming and more bridge building and such. So, just throwing it out there. Because I'd imagine that if we're going to stay here for any length of time, we'll develop a lot of this relatively quickly.
Yeah.
So.
I hope we can find like a plains, kind of a bigger area that's open, but we gotta start somewhere.
Right, and I think this is a perfectly fine place to start for right now.
Yeah, it's got gorgeous views.
Right?
Ah.
Good landscape.
Now, this is, just so you guys know as well, this is version, oh, where'd my log go? Dang it.
Do you need more? I have quite a few.
I'm gonna grab one of those out of the fire pit.
Okay.
I had enough logs and one disappeared on me. Uh-oh.
Let's see.
Alright, I need to make another fire pick. It's getting close to darky time. We gotta watch out for the zomberts.
Right.
Now, as you live in an area, the longer you stay there, you basically get, build up a zone of protection. Uh-huh. And it'll keep the zombies and bad things from spawning. Which, you know, it's a good thing.
It is a good thing. Yeah, I didn't realize this house was going to be quite this small when I threw it all together. My bad, yo.
Yeah, it's a little...
My bad.
It's a little tight.
We're going to be tight. Cuddly.
Yeah.
That's okay. With some tools, yeah, we can make it bigger.
Oh, and our first pit is open.
Okay.
You want to shift? You can shift and right-click and grab your jug. Grab a jug out of there. I'm going to go down to the water and right-click on the water, and it'll fill it up.
Awesome. And so these vessels act like mini backpacks.
Yeah, you can hold them in your inventory and they'll hold small items. So if you look at every item in TerraFirmaCraft has a weight and size. If you hover over it, it'll say like clay is light and tiny. Those vessels will only hold small and tiny things. Something looking at me over there.
Sneak and right click to place object or right click to open inventory.
Yep, you can shift, you can drop it on the ground like
there
that.
There we go. Okay. Well, you can. Oh, I like the little GUI that pops up there. That's cool. I approve. Hello, ores. Can all go in there.
You got more going. Oh, yeah, there's a thing. I think it could be an Enderman.
Let's hide.
I think you saw me.
Oh, well, if he saw you, you'd probably be dead by now, Rongo. No offense, sir, but...
He was looking right at me! Alright, well, I think we should probably pause and we'll come back in the morning.
Sure.
Otherwise, we're going to be standing here for the next few minutes just looking at each other. I mean, you are awful pretty.
Well, thank you. Master I appreciate Chief. That, right? Okay.
All right.
We'll be right back, guys.
All right, we're back, and there's a spider. Where is he at? Guy? Oh, he's on top of.
Oh, Dukes! I think I peed a little.
If you hold right trigger on a javelin, you can throw it. Oh yeah, take that. You want some of me, huh? He's gonna get you. Get some, spider. Get some.
Oh my god, this thing is so boss.
I know. All the things are boss in this game. Ah, get off me. Get off me.
Got him.
Ah, good job. Oh, that cost me 400 hit points.
Yeah, I knocked out about 200. But we have string, so just a few more string, we can make a fishing pole, maybe.
Yeah.
In like 10 years with this mod.
Exactly. Yeah.
Anywho, thank God there's just the one. Oh, my gosh. Okay.
Oh, gosh. All right.
So.
All right, so where were we?
We need to
before night fell and we had to
foraging,
hide.
Right?
Yes. Okay, so we're going to get... I'm going to pick up one of these vessels that... Cured. There we go. We'll grab this one. I'll right click on this and I'm gonna put 10 of our native copper chunks in there.
Where?
I'm gonna put it back in the ground. And before we do anything else, we need to make a pick mold. Oops, actually. So we can pour the molten stuff in it.
Okay.
And I pick mold. I was like, I think I did it wrong. Will it work anyway? It worked anyway. Okay, good.
How do I add my copper to your copper?
Oh, don't worry about it yet, because we need we want to do it in even units of 10.
Okay.
Because each tool that takes 100 units or one ingot.
Okay.
And anything else will just solidify again, because it'll cool back down, which is kind of cool and kind of sad.
All at the same time.
Yeah. Do you have any woods?
I do. In fact, I will have a few more woods here. I don't want to stop mid-chop. Give me just a second.
All right. Oh, yeah. No, you always want to chop to completion in this game.
All right.
I got it.
There you go. Oh, you got it?
If you want to, you can just feed the logs there you go. That works. That's good.
And then those are all aspen.
All right, so in 8 hours, we will have... We'll have the delicious copper for a pick head. Yay! So for now, I guess we need to probably just... so let me show these see these big... The big potteries?
Yes.
I'll put one there.
Okay.
And if you right-click on it, you'll see it's got two tabs.
Yep, I sure do. 9 slots is nice.
One is liquid. Yep. You can also pick it up. And if you click on it in your inventory, you can actually see a little, next to the chest armor, you'll see a little invisible backpack area. And you can put stuff, that's where you can put it.
Okay.
And then you can right-click on it, and you can say seal, and it actually puts a little lid on it.
Oh, come on, Chunks, pop back up. Por favor.
All right. So I'm gonna put some stone and a deer bladder and some raw hides that I've gotten so far.
And some sinew. How do I create the log pile?
Shift, right-click.
Oh, of course. Of course, shift, right-click.
Beautiful.
Not what I was thinking.
And there are all kinds of different woods in the game. I think there's like 8 or 12 different tree species, all with different colors. And about that many ores as well with different colors. So you can make cobblestones and all kinds of really cool builds. And this game's got a built-in microblock system. Once we get to crafting, we can actually craft a chisel that'll let us basically break a big block into 64... Well, actually, it's 8 cubed little blocks that we can tinker with. So you can actually carve tables and faces and stuff out of these big blocks, which is really cool.
Nice.
All right, so
you have a deer
right bladder. Now, I've got 12 ounces of food left.
I have 27.5.
Okay, I'm going to put some saplings down just so they can start regrowing.
Sure.
Bigger, might as well. In fact, might as well trees farm. They grow a block every, I think, month and a half or something like that. So it's not instant.
Can you bone meal them?
What a beautiful day! It's not raining, at least. We had several days where it just kept raining, so it was really
fog.
Kind of, it was foggy,
all the
and
fog.
Yeah, it was a thing. So we need. Well, I'm going to show the viewers at home this canyon. Also, along the shore, you'll find seaweed, which may be the way I live for a little while.
Yeah.
This lovely seaweed right here.
Because I'm under the impression that crops take forever.
Yeah, they take months to
grow.
Yep, so it's 96 game days. Each day is 20 minutes. And like the normal Minecraft, and there are 8 days per month, 12 months per year, 4 seasons, etc. And we've got a mod called Too Much Time. Oh, it's raining! Yay! Oh shit! Oh,
I forgot to say, you
almost had an arcade in.
Good times, good times.
Yeah, watch out for that sound, because like I said, the ground is a lot more unstable than Minecraft.
Mm-hmm.
So there's hematite down there. All right. Oh, the rain, the rain.
Sorry, the guys, rain I have a
put
very...
out torches?
It yeah, right. It will, but not the ground pit kiln things. It won't.
Right, the pit kiln burns hot enough to keep it going. Press S to stack your stuff. Go. Jack, like I mentioned earlier, that the torches will go out over time. Jack-o'-lanterns stay lit all the time. That's why it's good to use.
Yeah, lucked out finding those pumpkins.
Yeah. Be nice if you find a few more patches of them too.
Yeah, like so you put one in my head, I'm already starting to kind of devise a bridge from here, right over there, so that we don't have to fight the water.
Oh yeah, I like it.
But I think we're gonna need some other things before we do that. 2 hours remaining. All right.
A saw to make. Yeah, once we get a saw, so we need. I think that's our next thing is a saw. So once we get 8 more. How many more do we need? We have one. Yeah, once we get another 9 pieces of copper. Now, copper ore in the world, there is 3 quality stages. There's poor, regular, and high quality. And you'll get either 15, 25, or 35 units of copper or ore when you harvest those. And usually the whole vein is all the same.
Let's see, what did I use? I used maple. Okay.
There we go. Marvelous. All right, so we are... I'm going to grab one of these as well for...
I'm so used to shifting to, you know, go-go gadget legs.
Oh, yeah. This is a waiting game, literally a waiting game.
Well, you know, initially, but I think it will certainly pick up.
Rhyolite, claystone, and rhyolite goes there. There we go. Yeah, all the different types of ores all have their own sands and gravels, and they affect the color of the cobblestone you can make with clay and that ore. So we just need... Oh, it's out! The fire's out! Woohoo! Alright, so I'm going to grab the... Where you at, S'more?
Over here, buddy.
You're about to get picked, man.
Yikes, okay.
So I'm going to grab the anvil.
So what do you have? You have a copper ingot?
I've got copper ingot. I actually have liquid copper, and I've got a mold. I'm pouring the copper into the mold. Woohoo! Achievement earned.
Oh, okay.
Then I take that, open it up, pop it out, boop. Yeah, I throw it to the ground, and S'more grabs it.
Yoink, yoink, yoink.
Behind you.
Okay, I was about to say, I said yoink a lot. Didn't see it. Okay, gotcha. So there and then there. Excellent. Ooh.
You has pick.
All right, well, let's see what...
Our fates rest in your hands.
We should probably pick some better hands, I'll be honest. Of course, where I chose to dig, there's a friggin' water. You know what I mean? Like, of course I'd pick that.
Oh, wow. Literally, wow.
I sprung a leak. Now, so I filled it up, or at least I cut it off. But I think we're going to have to eliminate it and then dig it back out. Let's see how this goes.
Yeah, that seems interesting. I've not encountered underground water before here, so.
Surprise!
Surprise! Now,
just a few more pieces. S'more
has to watch out for cave-ins, because he's probably going to die.
Well, that's good to know.
So, later on, we'll get our saw. We can make supports that will keep that from happening. But we can't make those supports yet until we get a saw, and we can't make a saw until we get more Or...
I don't want to die. I don't... Oh, because I'm digging in dirt, no wonder.
Oh, God. Spore's going to die.
Well, hopefully not, but, you
but
know.
But you guys are going to have to wait till the next episode to see him die.
Oh, so that's we'll not very nice.
We're going to be doing some mining here off between episodes.
Yeah, oh, God, great thing to die. Do at night. Well, probably not. I mean, you know, probably not.
Actually, it's pretty safe at night, I would think.
Oh, gravel. Yikes. So I'm digging through a lot of soft stuff.
Yeah. Yeah. You get more logs?
I have a bunch. Do I need to come up and finish actually messing with the house?
No. Well, we're going to wrap it up here, though. So.
Okay.
When we come back, we will have found some more copper because we really need to find copper. And it's going to be a lot of just us digging to find copper. So when we come back, we will be able to move on maybe to the next little stage, maybe get some more things happening. So I hope you guys are enjoying this so far. Again, if you guys want to play along on the seed, the zip pack for all the files will be available at RongotheBold.com. And all you got to do is you have your Minecraft license and then do the setup-y stuff and all that kind of jazz. So we hope you guys like it. If you do, leave some comments. Tell us what you think. Oh, God, it's getting dark. And we'll see you later.
Bye, guys.
Bye.
Thank you for watching tomorrow. Like, comment, share, subscribe. For more, like, comment, share, subscribe for more.